Showing you live shots there from Sofitel's Harbor Garden tent in Pasay City for the seventh day of the filing of certificates of candidacy for national positions. Vice President Leni Robredo is now in the area to file her COC for president. Robredo finally announced her presidential bid this morning following growing clamor for her to seek the country's highest post. She's been endorsed by opposition coalition Isang Bayan. Robredo enters the crowded contest for the Philippine presidency with other candidates like Senator Manny Pacquiao and Panfilo Lacson, as well as Manila Mayor Isko Moreno. She will also face the son of late dictator Ferdinand Marcos, whom she defeated in the 2016 vice presidential race. Senator Francis Kiko Pangilinan is said to be the running mate of opposition presidential bet Leni Robredo. This is according to ABS-CBN news sources. The 58-year-old lawmaker is president of the once-ruling Liberal Party chaired by Robredo. Pangilinan previously led the campaign of the Otso Derecho slate in the 2019 midterm polls. Retired Supreme Court Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio, a convener of opposition coalition Isang Bayan, said they recommended a different running mate but notes they understand Robredo's choice. Carpio notes they are happy with Robredo's decision. Some of the bills authored and sponsored by Pangilinan were the Coconut Farmers and Industry Trust Fund Act, Anti-Money Laundering Act, and the Rent Control Law. Meantime, more senatorial aspirants lodged their certificates of candidacy a day before the deadline of filing, among them human rights lawyer Chael Diokno, who seeks another shot at the Senate seat. Diokno ran in 2019, but lost.
Sa mga nakaraang taon, napakaraming Pilipino ang sumagot sa hamon ng pandemya. Mga medical frontliner natin, na pati buhay ay itinaya para sa atin. Mga economic frontliner natin na siniguro na makaabot sa ating mga lamesa ang pagkain. Mga kabataan at ordinaryong mamamayan na nagkapit-bisig para makatulong. May isang sektor na nabubulok sa korupsyon. Isang sektor na nabubulok sa pang-aapi. Binubusog nila ang sarili nila sa pera at sa kapangyarihan ng bayan. Palagay ko, tama na yan eh. Sobra na yan. Kung ako'y bibigyan ng pagkakataon na magsilbi bilang isang senador, gagawin nating abot kamay ang hustisya.
Bayan Muna Chairman Nery Colmenares also formalized his senatorial bid, his third in such attempt.
ECQ, MECQ, granular lockdowns, alert level 1 to 4, lahat ng Q, naranasan na natin. Pero ni pagrampa sa testing at maayos na contact tracing, hindi magawa. Samantalang bilyon-bilyong piso ang winaldas o hindi napaglaanan ng maayos para makatugon sa COVID-19. Kailangan masawatan natin ang patuloy na pagraragasa ng COVID at ipaglaban sa Senado ang ayuda, trabaho, edukasyon at katarungan.
Former Vice President Jejomar Binay also seeking a political comeback, filing his COC for senator. And before we go, social media is set abuzz after Vice President Leni Robredo announced her presidential run. The hashtag LabanLeni2022 topped the trending list of Twitter Philippines, racking up over 248,000 tweets as of writing. Now, other trending topics include Lalaban Tayo, a line from Robredo's speech, and Register to Vote. Several social media users are also using the hashtag LetLeniLead to express their support for Robredo. But apart from that, popular Filipino band Eraserheads also ended up on the trending list. Its frontman Eli Buendia earlier promised a reunion if Robredo runs for president in 2022. We're going back to the live shots from Sofitel's Harbor Garden in Pasay City for the seventh day of the filing of certificates of candidacy. You're seeing Vice President Leni Robredo formalizing her presidential bid. Liberal Party President and Senator Francis Pangilinan is rumored to be her vice presidential running mate. Pangilinan was supposed to file his COC for Senate re-election on Wednesday, but he postponed this to give way to Robredo's announcement. Robredo finally announced her presidential bid this morning following growing clamor for her to seek the country's highest post. She has been endorsed by opposition coalition Isambayan. Now, Robredo enters the crowded contest for the Philippine presidency with other candidates like Senator Manny Pacquiao and Panfilo Lacson, as well as Manila Mayor Isko Moreno. She will also face the son of the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos, whom she defeated in the 2016 vice presidential race. And we're looking at videos still from Sofitel, Vice President Leni Robredo showing her COC as she filed her certificate of candidacy running for president in the 2022 elections today. All right, you can read part of her speech at 2022 PH presidential aspirant. Leni Robredo said she has wholeheartedly accepted the challenge to run for president because, in her words, she needed to free the nation and ourselves of the situation that the Philippines finds itself in. The war tagline, Lalaban Ako, has been prominent in that speech, which is also trending on social media right now. So earlier we had seen videos of the vice president at Sofitel as she filed her certificate of candidacy. She is now showing that document to her supporters.